we were talking about the role of parents, because you may have, you know, you may have the coaches, you may have this team that's surrounding an athlete, but then outside of that, it's a different story altogether. Napapangiti si Doc Karen. How important is that to have everything aligned? No, at pag hindi naman aligned, what then happens to the athlete?
So very important na yung term na alignment, no, with the coaches and the parents. Kasi if hindi siya aligned, mga malilito, no, yung athlete, and at the same time hindi siya natutulungan to the 100% potential. Kasi before, meron kami mga athlete na pagka bumibisita, patago because ayaw ni coach, no? Meron naman din athlete na required kasi gusto ni mama, may mga ganun, no? So, may mga iba-ibang reason. So, at the end of the day, very important pa rin that the parents, alam niya kung ano talaga, no, yung kahalagahan, ganun din yung coach. And then also for the athlete, kasi there are some athletes that, na they just go to us because for compliance. No, so nadi-defeat yung purpose. Yeah. Even if you design a program for them, kung hindi naman nila talaga parang alam yung importance, then it becomes useless. So very important yung sabi ni Nolly that education and awareness is very important for all people na nakasurround doon sa athlete.
When you talk about designing a program and you talk about, you know, raising these athletes, being there for them, coaching them, mm-hmm. is there a way to do this that is anchored on us being a Filipino, yeah. not just getting, you know, this is how Russia did it. This is how China did it. This is how the US did it. It worked for them. Maybe it'll work for us. What do you think about that, Coach Nolly?
There is definitely there is. We can come up with a Filipino way of coaching, of leading our athletes, and even our athletes looking at the perspective of them representing the country. You know, lagi nating binabanggit the Filipino resiliency na kahit daming bagyong dumadaan sa atin, andun tayo. Then that can be part of our sports philosophy, resiliency. Andun yung pagiging nating para, yung para sa bayan. Carmina, no? Marami tayong narinig, para sa bayan, para sa bayan, para sa bayan. Pero ano nga ba talaga ang para sa bayan? Maliwanag ba yan kay Heidi Lynn? Maliwanag ba yan sa ibang Olympians natin? Maliwanag ba yan sa naglaro sa World Championships? Maliwanag ba yan yung umabot lang sa SEA Games? I'm sure kung hindi yan maliwanag, then iba-iba yung hashtag para sa bayan. No, at napakahalaga siguro lalo na ngayon na meron na tayo sa first time meron na tayong Olympic medal. Magandang pagkatapos nito, pag pwede na tayong magkita-kita. Let's all come up with a common ground. And alam mo, Carmina, you know, yung mental health. Somebody who's bothered, he or she expresses himself or herself better if he or she finds himself or herself in a safe ground, in a common ground with someone. Pag hindi ka safe, you won't open up. And I think coming up with a common ground wherein all the stakeholders, and maalis na tong Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, maging Pilipinas lang. No? And I think very important yung framing of our stories. Di ba? Napakahalaga yan. Paano mo paulit-ulit ang isang angulo, yan yung nagiging totoo. And if, again, binanggit ko, is there a way we can teach Filipinos in sports a way of thinking? Yes, we don't have to go far. Resiliency has always been about us. Not being afraid to go the distance, our OFWs, para sa bayan, para kanino lang ito, para rin to sa pamilya mo, para to sa mga kasama mo. I was looking at Team HD, apat, those are the important stakeholders. Pamilya, which is the parents, the coaches, the administrators, and then the community. If those at least four key stakeholders would sit down and talk about a common ground, a common mindset, so much can be done and so much can be achieved.
I want to talk about, because we have been talking about, you know, what it takes to be an athlete and all that, and, you know, the mental exercise and physical exercise that each and every athlete has to go through in order to fulfill whatever dream they have, whether it's an Olympic dream or any other dream. But when the pandemic struck, right, that really changed everyone's lives. But more so the athletes, hindi alam ng marami kung paano ito naka-apekto sa ating mga atleta. We had on the program Akiko Thompson and Stephen Fernandez. And they did say, and we didn't have enough time to explore that. But I want to talk about it now. How did this pandemic really affect our athletes, especially in the run-up to the Tokyo Olympics? Coach Nolly.
I've never been involved in the elite athletes, such as, unlike Karen, but I've been involved in the university sports. And if there's one thing I realized here is we have to emphasize or help our athletes define themselves na hindi lang anchored sa pagiging atleta. In fact, Carmina, naging inspirasyon to sa akin, kaya gumawa ako ng program. After na nung MWF namin that I have been sharing to many sports associations, yung sports at iba pa. No, na napakahalaga yung at iba pa na may buhay outside sports. And you know, I've been reading nung Lunes nung nanalo si Heidi Lynn, I read her essay sa libro namin. Parang binanggit niya rito na ang pagiging niyang tao hindi lang nadi-define ng pagiging niyang weightlifter. Nadi-define din to ng kanyang pagiging babae at pagiging anak. At napakahalaga yun na matulungan natin ang ating mga atleta, lalo na kahit anong larangan, na sila ay tao, kapatid, anak, asawa, at atleta. Kung mawala yung pagiging atleta, bahagi lang yun ang kanilang kabuuan.
Kasi naramdaman nila yun, hindi ba, Coach Nolly and also Doc Karen, when the pandemic struck and training for most of them stopped for a while, they sort of lost the definition as to who they are. And they were also scared. Anong mangyayari, hindi ba? So in Heidelin's case, for example, Doc Karen, how did that manifest itself? When the pandemic struck, what did you see in her? And how did she cope with it?
Okay, so very true, no? Yung sinabi ni Sir Nolly regarding yung athletic identity kasi nila. And that athletic identity is a big part of who they are. Kaya talagang nagulat sila eh. Parang nawala sila sa routine, nawala sila, sino ba ako? No, because before they are training twice a day, tas biglang bawal kasi restricted. Tapos they don't know in terms of yung goals nila before was ito, tong competition na to. Bigla rin siyang nawala. No, so talagang parang sila, ha? Sino ako? Ano nang gagawin ko? No? So, tama si Sir Nolly, yung ginawa ko kay Heidelin Diaz or even with other athletes, pinapagwent ko sila ng malaking circle. Tapos sa malaking circle na yon, sabi ko, this is you. Then create smaller circle. Yung maliliit na circle na yan, yan yung mga roles mo in life. No? So, you're an athlete, you're a student, you're a daughter, you're a friend, you're a cousin. So, ang dami. No? So, as you can see, one part lang dyan yung pagiging atleta mo. You can be so much more. No, kasi I remember it nung nanalo siya sa Rio 2016. Sabi niya, Dok, kaya ko pa ba ng isang cycle? So sabi ko sa kanya, ibabalik ko sa iyo yung tanong. Kaya mo pa ba? Sabi niya, kasi I'm going to do yung training ko ng ganito every day for the next 4 years. No? So tinanong ko siya, aside from winning, no, aside from Olympics, ano po ba yung gusto mo in life? Sabi niya, gustong-gusto ko, Doc, magkaroon ng diploma. That's why naghanap kami ng school na pwede doon sa schedule niya. No? So naging ano siya, student. Tapos in-explain ko sa kanya, ang pagiging student, you will learn a lot, no, from there. Kasi in time management, you're going to meet people outside the sports. Yeah. Tapos matututo ka. And according to sa mga studies nga, pag ang isang atleta matagal sa pag-aaral, mas nagiging magaling sila sa sport kasi yung cognitive ability nila na di-develop. Mm-hmm. Tapos they are also open, no, for learning kasi doon natututunan yun sa school. Kaya nga sinasabi ko sa coaches, it is very important that we encourage our student athletes to proceed, to continue with schooling. Kasi marami silang matututunan pag nag-aaral sila. So ganun, no? So siguro yung question din kanina, paano siya matitailor fit sa isang Pilipino? Dapat kilalanin natin ang husto, no, yung isang atleta. Kasi pag kilala mo siya, madidesign mo base sa ano yung gusto niya.
Yeah.
No, katulad kay Heidelin, makikita mo, she's also very faithful no, sa faith niya.
Yes.
So mga activities din ako na pinapagawa sa kanya na naka-incline doon. No? Katulad yan, minsan, pag nasa-stress siya, I ask her to listen to music na medyo more or less, nyari, praise and worship. So yung music itself will set a good environment for her. Mm-hmm. So ganun. So the more that you know the person, the better that you can create activity na naka-incline talaga sa kanya. So I think yun yung pagiging Filipino eh. Yung pakikisama, pakikiramdam, patanong-tanong, yan ang mga importanteng karakteristik ng isang tao para mas ma-design mo siya na bagay sa Pilipino.
The reality though is, Doc Karen and Coach Nolly, is that this kind of a support group at this point costs a lot, right? And for many of our aspiring athletes, they see a sport sometimes as a way out of poverty. At pag dun mo sinimulan, nandun na kaagad yung pressure. Diba? For most of our athletes na dala ko yung buong bata pa lang, diba? Dala ko yung buong pamilya. The story of Senator Manny Pacquiao. Dala niya yung buong pamilya niya. He had that resiliency. But should it be the same story for each and every aspiring athlete, Coach Nolly?
You know, I believe it should not be the template that all the athletes can follow. It depends on the context that you are in. Of course, maganda yung, again, sa tingin ko, pagiging Pilipino, gusto natin yung may anggulo ng too much difficulty.
Hmm.
You know, but if there's also one thing that this pandemic gave us, Carmina, no, is the opportunity to reach out to a lot of people via online. Hmm. And I think for all the athletes listening here, to the parents and to the coaches, take the opportunity to also to reach out to people who may be able to be of help. Hindi kailangan sagot sa unang yung tanong. They can guide you to the person who may have the answer. Hmm. Kasi paminsan ang una nating tinatanong, sino ang makakasagot? If there's one thing I realized, and I think this has also guided us in the creation of the book, sometimes yung una mong pupuntahan, hindi yan yung sagot. Siya lang sa'yo yung mag-guide para dun sa taong makakasagot ng tanong mo.
Hmm.
And for I encourage everyone really to consider reaching out and reconnecting. Hindi lahat may kakayahan bumuo ng isang solid team HD, pero lahat may kakayahan magtanong at mag-reach out at maghanap ng kasagutan.
Let's start first with the immediate circle, which is of course the family of an athlete, di ba? Oftentimes, and I've seen this happen because I'm also trying to raise athletes in our home. I'm raising three swimmers. It's tough. It's tough, and you know, you see some parents who are even more stricter than the coaches, and hindi aligned yung sinasabi halimbawa ni Doc Karen kanina. If there's any guiding principle that you want to impart to parents of athletes, what should that be, Coach Nolly?
Shape them to be better people first. Before you think about creating better athletes, think first about shaping better young men and women. Napag-usapan natin, Carmina, at nabanggit mo nga kanina si Rico Navarro, naalala ko lang ngayon yung topic niya sa aming MWF session. And I thank you for reminding me of my dear friend. Ang topic niya doon was this philosophy of the New Zealand All Blacks, the mighty rugby team of New Zealand. Ang number one philosophy ng New Zealand is better people make better All Blacks.
Mm.
That before you become somebody to represent our country, make sure that you're a better person first. And going back to the family, parents should always think about, ito bang gagawin ko? Sisigaw ako? Kakausapin ko yung coach? Pag nakita ba ito ng anak ko, hindi ko siya kailangan paliwanagan, hindi ko kailangan magsinungaling para lang ma-justify ko kung bakit ko ginawa yung ginawa ko. Our actions, more than our words, are the strongest examples of our children. And I think parents who are listening, parents who have athletes as for kids as athletes, napakahalaga ngayon yung pananaw at paano niyo ito binibigay sa inyong mga anak sa panahon na hindi nila na-define ang sarili nila as athletes.
Mm-mm. Yeah. Katulad nga, and we go back to what you were saying, Doc Karen, and Coach Nolly as well, that whole exercise about the circle and being part of other subsets as well, that being an athlete is just one aspect of their person, of their identity. You know, it's been how many hours since you got back, Doc Karen?
Less than 20 hours. Yesterday, like 6 p.m. yesterday.
Yeah. And so far, she hasn't really fully rested. Of course, we're talking about Heidi Lynn Diaz. But you know what they're talking about, right? Hindi pa siya nakakapahinga, hindi pa siya nakaka, you know, spending time with herself and all that. Mm-hmm. And already people are talking about concerns that some people are out there to take advantage of her. How mm-hmm. real is that for Heidi Lynn Diaz now? And what are you doing to make sure that nothing of that sort will happen to her?
Okay, the situation right now is kind of difficult because we never planned of anything after Tokyo. Ganun kami ka-focus. Parang when we are having meetings before, lahat ng plano after Olympics, saka na natin pag-usapan yan after Olympics, no? And then biglang boom, no? Biglang nanalo siya, and then biglang ang daming offers, ang daming lumalapit, ang daming tao. So parang ngayon, hanggang ngayon, hindi niya alam, no? Kaya laging ang sagot niya, hindi ko alam, hindi ko pa alam. Kasi totoo yun, no? People from the media are asking, what are you going to do with your money? What are you going to do after the Olympics? It's true na hindi niya pa alam because we thought itong quarantine will be her mental health break. No?
Yeah.
Magpapahinga sana siya because I encourage her na, oh, you can answer some interviews for 2 or 3 hours lang and then the rest of it, you enjoy, no? You enjoy. Mm-hmm. Actually, meron pa siyang pang-exercise sa loob ng room niya eh. Kasi ganun siya, yung identity niya as athlete, she requested for it, no? Mm-hmm. Kasi gusto niya mag-exercise pa rin, gusto niya pawisan siya. So I think all of this is very important in a sense that kailangan meron siyang me time. Kasi at the end of the day, it's always siya, no? Kung ano yung gusto niya, not other people around her. And we always remind her, you go back to your basic, no? Like talk to your parents, talk to the people who were there, no? During the time na you're still starting.
Coach Nolly, what about those who are out to take advantage of her? I mean, you've heard of the talks going around and the fear that, you know, she's prime target. For, you know, people are out to take advantage of her and her popularity now. What are your thoughts on that, Coach Nolly?
You know, Carmina, I was talking with a good friend of mine and when he told me about this, natatawa ako sa umpisa, pero it makes sense. Mm-hmm. Heidi Lynn should look for her own Jerry Maguire.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody, you know, that movie Jerry Maguire.
Yes.
Somebody who's so good in managing the life of an athlete, but who will love her in return. Like somebody, mm-hmm. like yung Jerry Maguire, the Kwan, the love, the sincere love. And I think napakahalaga yun sa buhay niya. I've been a friend of Heidi Lynn for many years now. Madaling lapitan si Heidi Lynn, pero that was before Tokyo. That was before Tokyo. To be honest, I never, nagpadala lang akong message kay Heidi Lynn 3 days after kasi alam ko, but nagpadala lang rin ako ng mas explicit na mensahe kay Julius. Sabi ko, Jules, I don't think Heidi Lynn is gonna read pa with all these things. Mm-hmm. And I can imagine there's so many people, and ito pa, mag-election na, the politicians, and I think there should be a rule there na kung ano yung gagawin niya, ano yung, ako to be safe here, don't go into rallies anymore, just kasi pag pinagbigyan mo ang isa, alam natin dito, pag kailangan mong pagbigyan lahat at utang na loob, if you get stuck into it, it's gonna be a thread of a problem.
Yeah, so what do you tell her about that, Doc Karen, to make sure that, you know, she establishes that balance within herself? Because baka nag-aagaw, hindi ba? We know that a lot of people supported mm-hmm. her. And we know because she is who she is, tinatanaw na yon, niya yon na utang na loob.
Mm-hmm.
Pero katulad nga ng sinabi ni Coach Nolly, baka mapunta sa ibang, mm-hmm. you know,
Yeah.
So actually, what did you tell her?
Yeah, mahirap in a sense because yung utang na loob is very difficult to pay, no? Kaya sinasabi namin it's better not to have utang na loob from the start. Kasi yan ang utang na loob na mahirap mong bayaran. You cannot pay. So sabi ko, you really have to be wiser in a sense, no? Remember na who you are as an athlete and more or less you as a person. So yun. So I think naman now she's thinking in terms of what she's going to do.
Okay, final thoughts. So they just told us now that we're running out of time. We do have time for a short message to the future athletes of this country. Doc Karen, you go first. Coach Nolly, your message after Doc Karen. What do you tell all those who may be watching us right now, mm-hmm. who are looking up now to Heidelin Diaz, thinking I could be that person too one day?
Okay, so nothing is impossible, no? So in term na impossible, that should be I'm possible. Everything that you dream of, pwede siyang mangyari with the right yung hard work, with the right training, with the right determination, and with the right people around you. It can happen.
Yeah. Thank you, Doc Karen Trinidad there. And Coach Nolly Ayo?
And again, inspired by Heidi Ling's recent achievement para sa mga nakikinig na mga bata, lahat ng mga nangangarap, those who may not be an Olympian but who wants to be part of this exciting world of sports, walang mabigat na hindi kayang mabuhat. Subalit, you need the right team with you. Pwede mong mabuhat sa umpisa, but the sustaining it, the faithfulness to the process, having a good team surrounding you would be a big thing. So I encourage you as you move forward, even if you're the best in your field, sports will not always be about you. You will need an ecosystem. You will need an environment. Find the ecosystem. Find the environment that will bring out the very best in you. We all saw that with Heidi Lin, and what a shining moment she gave all of us.
Coach Nolly Ayo, Athletics Director of Ateneo de Davao, and of course the sports psychologist of our golden girl, Heidelin Diaz, Coach Karen Trinidad there. Thank you so much, guys, for joining us tonight. Really appreciate you having be with us here on the show. Maraming salamat sa inyong dalawa.
Thank you.